Hello, hello, hello. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you may be. Welcome back to my channel, My Loverlies. If you've never been here before, thank you so much for clicking on my video. I am so happy you found me. I do so hope that you will like and subscribe before you leave. Become part of the Mama family. Mama's got your back, at least where makeup's concerned, and definitely when that makeup is cheap. Today we have a teeny tiny little what's new at Birks kind of video. So I went to Birks probably about a week ago now. I have been very patiently waiting to dive into all of these products so I could do it with you guys. But last time I went, I actually found quite a few super, super cute, really affordable little things. So I picked them up. I am, like I said, super stoked to share them with you guys. We're just going to go through everything, pick out what we like, what we don't, what's amazing, what's not. I think that Birks, it's not even really a haul because there's not a ton here, but I just think that there's so much fun. I think that it's so much fun to just continuously see what's new at discount stores because, everything trickles down from the higher ups and then it trickles down through the channels and ends up at TJ Maxx, Birks, Marshalls, things like that. And, you never know what you're going to find. I think that's the best part of it. It's like a treasure hunt, right? Because in the piles upon piles of absolute garbage that is usually there, sometimes you really do find things that are just so, so worth it. My little hidden treasures. So we're going to go ahead and dive right in. I will, of course, list everything that I talk about in today's video in the description box below. If you guys are wondering what is on my face right now, I do have a TikTok and a reel coming on this look very, very shortly. I think I look beautiful today. I love the way that my eyes turned out. I think my skin looks absolutely fabulous. I have my NYX Born to Glow. No, I used my Givenchy. I used my Givenchy Prisma Libre foundation today, but it reminds me very, very much of my NYX Born to Glow. I wore this yesterday, and I think the finish on the skin is almost identical. I think the NYX has a little bit more coverage, but overall, I think they are so incredibly similar. I'm thinking about doing a dupes video on this. So if you guys would like to see that, please let me know. I'm probably going to do it anyway, just because I think that they're so, so similar, but this is a really good one. The Givenchy was sent to me to review by Influencer. But this I bought with my own money. And I'll tell you what, they are so, so similar. I don't think I would ever pay for the Givenchy one because this one looks so much like it. So I do have that all over my face. I actually used a couple of the things that we're going to talk about in today's video on my face as well. We'll get into that. But if you're wondering about how I did my eyes, I used the Beauty Bay New Mood Palette. Guys, this palette is so incredibly underrated. I haven't heard anybody really talking about this palette. It made a little bit of noise when it first was launched. It's one of the newer releases from Beauty Bay, but guys, I am telling you, this is so, so stunning. So at first glance, the color story really doesn't look like anything special, right? It's one of those color stories that you really have to dive into. You have to experience it to really appreciate the full like amazingness of it because you do have two duochromes in here. So this one right here and this one right here are both duochromes. It's showing up green on my camera, but if I were to show it, I think there was a way that you could show it in like the mirror. Let me see if I can figure this out. Okay. Yeah. Can you guys see that flip? So it turns red a little bit. I'm going to have to figure out how to do that. I heard that if you like show multi or duochromes in a mirror, it helps show the flip. But it's green to red. It's really, really beautiful. And then this one up here, it changes from gold to pink. It is so, so stunning. I have this one on my all over my lid today. Really, really beautiful. I just think this color story is fantastic. You've got tons of neutrals in here, which makes it perfect for an everyday palette. But then you've also got like complementary, like little pops of color. You've got pink, green, and blue. It's perfect. It's a really beautifully well thought out and wonderfully executed palette, and it is so affordable. And on top of that, I stan the Beauty Bay formula. I think it's absolutely fantastic. Both the mattes and metallics are absolutely, they're truly genius. They're so good. If you haven't tried the Beauty Bay formula, definitely should do that at some point, just because it's totally worth experiencing. It is so good. One of my very, very favorite brands, quickly becoming one of my very, very favorite brands. But that's what I have on my face. Tutorial is coming very, very soon. But let's go ahead and dive into to our little mini haul. So the first thing I want to highlight is these right here. So I picked up these. These were marked down from like $3.99. I don't know if you can see that. I got these for $1. They must have been sitting around for a good long while. And I can assume that the reason people didn't pick these up is because you can't tell what color it is, right? It doesn't say a color on here at all whatsoever. I think the packaging on these is really, really gorgeous. I did get super curious and open one up just to see again what the color was, because I had no idea. There is no way of telling what the color is just by looking at the packaging. But you open, first of all, the packaging is so incredibly adorable. These are the Revlon Ultra HD Lip Colors. These are stunning. So it comes in this really, really gorgeous metallic red and silver packaging. And it's got this little thing, this little, I'm not even sure what it is. It looks like a dropper, but it's not. You just kind of twist it up and it pops out, and it is the most glorious orange color. On top of that, I put this on my lips, and guys, it's, I want to say it's a cross between a lip oil and a, like a lip gloss. It is so good. It feels so nice. Beautifully pigmented. There's a sheer quality to it, but it, like, the color shows up on your lips. I want to put it on, but there's another lip gloss here that I actually put on today that is so stunning. I really want to show that to you as well, but I am so in love with this. You guys know orange, my absolute favorite, one of my absolute favorite colors. Orange, pink, and coral. I just love so much. And I can see myself wearing this so often. And to be able to pick it up for $1, y'all. I really don't think that if, I really think that if this had been any color, I would have been happy with it, just because the formula is so luscious. It's luscious and nourishing on the lips. It is so good. So if you guys see these, pick these up, especially if they're only $1. And I think it's crazy that you get two of these for $1. I absolutely love it. And I think the packaging is so cute. Love. So the next lip glosses I wanted to talk to you guys about are these ones. Now these are the Mally H3 Lip Gloss Trio. So I picked this up because I was intrigued. So it says originally this is $17 for three lip glosses. You guys know, not in a million years would I ever pay that for a lip gloss. But it was marked down to $3.99. So I did pick it up. And the thing, first of all, I thought the packaging was so cute. It's just got this, looks like funfetti on the front. It's just really pretty. I like the aesthetic of it. And then I picked it up and I was like, that's lip gloss. It feels so heavy, right? So I had to pay for it, and then I had to get it home in order to open it up and really look at it. It does tell you the colors of the glosses. On the back, you have Shimmering Nude, Orchid Berry, and Pink Daisy, right? I thought the names were super cute as well. But what was really intriguing to me about this is how heavy it is. Now, I've never heard of this brand before. I've never heard of the brand Mally, but I'm assuming that they're kind of like mid-level, because, you know, $17 is not exactly cheap for lip gloss, right? Well, I opened it up. You open it up and it comes like this. Again, the inner packaging is really beautiful as well. And these are the three colors that you get. So these two are just straight up glossy. And this one has a little bit of like a glitter reflect to it. Guys, I want to talk to you about the actual component really quickly though, because oh my goodness gracious, this feels so incredibly high end. I am so stoked. This is the one that I have on my lips today. It is so incredibly beautiful. They just feel so good on the lips. They're not sticky at all. they have a really beautiful kind of slip to them. And then it's a fully saturated, like beautifully pigmented gloss. It just goes on. It makes your lips, it like erases all of your lines. It makes your lips look so full and so luscious. I am so, so in love with it. This is the shade Pink Daisy. That's what it looks like swatched. So, so pretty. Super, super shiny. Then you have the shade Berry Orchid. Yeah, Orchid Berry. And this one I tried on yesterday and it is so pretty. Even more pigmented than the first. I love this really beautiful purple toned pink. It is so incredibly beautiful. And look how glossy and shiny they are. Oh, so, so yummy. And then last but not least, we have Shimmering Nude. And I haven't tried this one yet. So this will be a first for both of us. Ooh, that's really pretty. That's kind of like a mauve-y, like mauve-y brown. That is so, so pretty. Guys, the actual components feel so good. They feel so luxurious and so high-end. I love it. I love when I can go to Berks and pay like pennies, right? For this really beautiful, gorgeous, luxurious kind of feeling. It feels like I'm treating myself without having to pay for it. And I love it. I love it so, so much. These components are so, so nice. They just feel heavy and it feels like glass. It's not. It's just really beautiful, heavy acrylic. It is so, so nice. So if you come across these at TJ Maxx, Marshall, Berks, where what have you, definitely pick these up. These are so, so worth it. If you're any, and you guys know how I am about my lip products anyway, I collect them so, so much. And I don't have anything in my collection that looks quite like this. I think the packaging is quite unique and so incredibly beautiful. Very, very happy about that. And then they just all like nestle in there together and look so cute. So I was super happy about this. This is probably one of my favorite things that I picked up that day when I went, just because it is so fantastic. Love that. And I love the colors in there as well. I think this one in particular, Pink Daisy, what was it? Yeah, Pink Daisy is so pretty. It's kind of like this universal pink. It's not super bright, but it's just pink enough to really give your lips this really beautiful, youthful kind of blushy tone. So, so stunning. And I just love the way that it makes my lips look. So, so good. Next, I picked up, you guys know that I talk about W7 all the time. Now, W7 is a European brand. They're like a European drugstore brand. So I want to kind of equate them to maybe Wet n Wild or NYX, things like that. But they're so, so cute. And I came across these. And these are the soft, these are the soft hues. They're these are very much like Makeup Revolution. It is 100% Makeup Revolution. Makeup Revolution is a European brand as well. But they're pretty much like Makeup Revolution, almost the exact same vibes. They do a lot of dupes. They do a lot of like kind of copycat vibes for sure. I don't mind that. If I can get it for less, then I'm going to get it for less. But I picked up these. These are the Soft Hues 9-Pan Palettes. I have the Aquamarine and Rose Quartz. Now, I believe these are supposed to be duping the Huda Beauty pastel palettes. So we're definitely going to try these out. I picked them up because they just look so, so pretty. I'm really excited about the Aquamarine one. I haven't swatched any of these, so let's do that together. And these were $3.99. Well, they have $3.99 on the sticker, but I believe they rang up for $2.99 for me. And I think that was with my my Berks discount. So definitely worth it. And I enjoy the W7 formula. Very, very similar again to Makeup Revolution. They're just good. They can be hit or miss. I've never played with any of their pastels before. But that looks pretty nice to me. I do enjoy the shimmers quite a bit. Let's go into this really pretty kind of swirled one and see what that looks like. Ooh, that is like super, super creamy. That's what it looks like. That is pretty. Oh yeah, I'm super excited to play with this. And then I got the Rose Quartz one as well. And this one just looks like, this looks like Easter and a palette for sure. I love pastels. This one looks, some of the tones look like they might be pretty similar. That yellow is super pretty. Oh, I love. Ooh, let's go into this really beautiful, like, yellow shimmer. That's probably one of the biggest reasons I picked this palette up. I'm always on the lookout for a good yellow shimmer. Not exactly gold. A really beautiful, like, baby duck yellow. That's what it looks like on the finger. Super, super metallic. Their metallics always feel so creamy and dreamy. They're super sheer, but they're so reflective. I am happy with that. I can't wait to play with these. So expect these to be in a video very, very shortly. And then I also picked up the Bare All Exposed and Bare All Uncovered. And again, these are dupes, I believe, for Huda Beauty palettes. But these color stories just looked so pretty, I couldn't resist. So the Bare All Exposed looks like this, really pretty. I want to call this neutral. It's not exactly warm, but it's not exactly cool either. If anything, in the pan, it looks to be leaning more towards the cooler side of things, but it looks so pretty. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mattes and 4 shimmers. Let's go in. I already know that I really enjoy the W7 mattes. They're always super creamy and easy to work with. Yeah, nicely pigmented. But let's go into one of the shimmers. Well, you guys know we got to dip into that one. Let's dip into the shimmer. Again, it's got that really beautiful, super creamy, metallic feel to it. They feel almost wet. And then when you swatch, ooh, that is so pretty. I am super excited to play with this one as well. It seems to me that the formulations are pretty similar in every palette. So if I like one, I will probably like them all. This is definitely a warm toned palette. This one, you guys know, stole my heart the minute I saw it and I had to pick it up. I also really enjoy this kind of plastic packaging. It's also kind of like tinted, so it's got this slight pink tint to it. I don't know. You guys know I enjoy those little details and it just looks cute. It's super adorby. These are super tiny, so really easy to stick in a bag or travel with if necessary. Really adorable, but what do we even swatch in here? Let's go right into the middle. I already know I'm gonna like the mattes. Ooh, that feels good. That feels good. That feels a little bit stiffer and more substantial. Yeah, that definitely does not look as sheer as the other formula. Whoa. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I can 100% see this becoming a very real everyday favorite for me. This is gorgeous. Let's go into this really beautiful deep chocolatey kind of color. Yeah, baby. Yeah. I don't think that you can have too many little palettes like this, especially neutral tones, because they're just perfect. Like, they're just perfect for every day. You guys know that I keep go bags in all of my purses. I have little go kits that have eyeshadow palette, matching lip gloss, eyeliner, mascara, stuff like that. This is 100% one of those palettes that I would stash in a go bag. It is so good. And because it is such a beautifully warm toned, kind of almost rosy color story, I can see it going with like almost anything, right? So this is a great buy. The formulation is fantastic. I am super excited to play with this in an upcoming video. While we're on the subject of eyeshadows and W7 in general, I picked up one last W7 palette. This is the W7 Nudification. So it's a W7 Nudification palette. This was $5.99. And I got it at a discount. I don't know if you guys can see that, but the mirror is cracked. So I actually got this a little bit cheaper than the $5.99. And this is what the color story looks like. Now, I'm gonna give you like 2 seconds to tell me what this is a dupe of, because it should be fairly obvious. I am almost positive this is a dupe of a Too Faced palette. I'm gonna have to look it up to really be sure of it. But I just thought that the colors in here were so super pretty. But because I picked up the other W7 smaller 9 pan palettes, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm going to save this and I'm gonna put it in the giveaway. I actually did contact the winner of the giveaway that I was doing for the end of September, beginning of October. That giveaway ended on the 10th. So I contacted the winner. Yeah, I contacted the winner today. I actually found I did the whole picking process yesterday because it ended on the 10th. So I closed the unpinned all that good stuff yesterday. But guys, please expect another giveaway in the very, very near future. I do have quite a few goodies for another giveaway. I'll probably give it about a month, but there is another one coming in the very near future. And I've got lots of really, really good, yummy stuff to put in there. I'm actually going to add this to the pile. I just love the W7 formulas so, so much. I think the mats are absolutely almost perfect. They build, they blend, they're just good. They're just good. And this is such a pretty everyday kind of palette. I think this color story would work with just about any and everyone. So I think this is a great kind of palette to put into the giveaway. So there's that. I also picked up this W7 bronzer. So this is the W7 Bronze Icon Bronzing Powder. I picked this up because I thought the packaging was super pretty. I'm not like a package snob, packaging snob or anything like that. I believe that what really matters is the formula inside. But I am, you know, I do enjoy pretty things. And I thought this was so, so pretty. I just love the look of it, right? It just looks bronze and tan. It reminds me of the sun and vacation for some reason. It's just so, so pretty. So this is what it looks like. You open it up and this is what it looks like on the inside. And I couldn't be happier with this bronzer if I had made the color myself. It's actually what I'm wearing today. I think it looks absolutely flawless on my skin tone. This is in the shade, I don't even know if it has a shade. It says just bronzing powder. Yeah, it does. I don't think it has a shade. It's just the W7 Bronze Icon Bronzer. But this is the most gorgeous, gorgeous bronzer. I'm going to swatch it for you because it is, oh, and the formulation of this is super soft. It feels velvety smooth on the fingers. It blended out absolutely effortlessly. It just looks so beautiful on my skin tone. It gives me just a little bit of that like bronzing that I like. Guys know that I prefer a cooler toned bronzer to help kind of sculpt and chisel my face out just a little bit. And this 100% did that. I'm going to swatch it for you really, really quickly. But I mean, it's perfect. It is perfect. Not too red, but not too orange. It's not so cool toned that it looks like gray on my skin. It is everything. And I actually like that it's a little bit deeper. I do want to compare this to my absolute favorite bronzer of all time. You guys know that this is the bronzer that I measure everything else against. This is my L'Oreal Lumi Bronze It. I will say that the Lumi bronzer, the formulation is even silkier and even smoother. It is still absolutely my favorite. But there are the two colors together. This one is definitely, my Lumi Bronze It is gently pigmented. So it's really easy to build and really customize the amount of bronze that you want. This one, the W7 one, is definitely more pigmented. And it's definitely a rosier tone as well. Not quite red, but it's got that little bit more of like that pinky gray undertone. But because it has that pinky gray undertone, it makes it perfect for sculpting. I feel like my face looks so sculpted today. I'm just so in love with it. So yes, this is a really, really good find. This was $3.99. That's what I paid for it. I would do that again in a heartbeat. It says originally it goes for $6. So almost half off. Guys, this is beautiful and I absolutely love the packaging. It's a little bit chunky. She's a chunker, but she's beautiful, so we don't mind. So, so pretty. We're almost to the end of it. I think I only have a couple more things to talk to you guys about. I lucked out and I found some mascaras. Now, I don't usually purchase mascara from Burke's and discount stores like that because y'all have no idea if A, somebody's been into it already, how long it's been sitting, things like that. You don't even know if it's going to be usable by the time you get it home because mascara is one of those things that 100% has a shelf life, right? The older mascara gets, the clumpier, lumpier, and grosser it usually gets. But I saw these and I just had to pick them up. So the first one is the Virtuose Precious Cells. It's a Lancôme. It is a Lancôme mascara and I have never tried a high-end mascara. So I really wanted to pick it up. I was super, super excited. Just to even own a high-end mascara. This was not expensive at all. And I mean, look at that. I don't want to open it because I'm not ready to use it, but it just is so, so pretty. I think the packaging is how they get you on these, right? It's just absolutely stunning, but this isn't even my favorite one. So this was the Virtuose Precious Cells Mascara. This is in the shade Precious Black. It says it's high definition lengthening mascara that's smudge resistant. We love everything about that. But, and then I saw this one. So this one is the, what is this one? This is the Hypnose Star Waterproof. It's like this was just sitting there waiting for me to see it. You guys know that I have to wear a waterproof mascara because my eyes water like nobody's business. If I don't put a waterproof mascara on, I'm just going to look like I've been crying all day, and that's not a good thing. So when I saw this was waterproof, I was like, yes, we need this in our lives. Come home to mama. And then I got it. And then I got it home and I opened it and I was like, what? This is probably it is definitely the prettiest tube of mascara I have ever seen in my life. It is absolutely stunning. I like the way that it feels. It's heavy. This glitter down here is textured, not unpleasantly so. It just kind of feels good. It's very tactile. Feels nice in the hand. It's got a nice weight to it. It feels high end, and it should be for a $25 mascara. That's not what I paid for it, but originally it goes for $25. Guys, I have this on my eyes today. I have had this makeup on all day. Oh, no. Oh, I think, is that my mascara or is that my eyeliner? That's my eyeliner. Not the mascara's fault. My eyes are super, super watery today, and my e.l.f. No Budge eyeliner cannot take the heat today, but I don't have any smudging from the actual mascara. I think my eyes still look absolutely fantastic. So I am not mad about it at all. I've had it on all day. I don't have any flaking. I don't have any smudging. I am super excited about this. It's one of those things that you love it, but you're also really mad at it because you fall in love with it. And then you realize I am never going to pay for this. I am never going to be able to repurchase this unless I somehow luck out and find another tube of it at my Birks next time I go, or at some time in the future. So I'm going to nurse this tube of mascara for as long as I possibly can. I love the way that it makes my eyelashes look. It says it is a show-stopping eyes mascara. It says it has 24-hour hold. That's about all it says. I just think the packaging is beautiful. I love what it did to my lashes. I'll look up so you guys can see how long they look. They are so long. They look thick and full. I'm just really in love with it. I paid $12 for this mascara. That's a lot. That is a lot to spend on a mascara. I can't justify it. I can't justify it. I saw it and I wanted it. I really, really wanted to try a Lancôme mascara. I'm glad that I did because I am incredibly in love with it. But I would say that I will never repurchase it. I will go back to my Essence Lash Princess. Guys, I love this so, so very much. But I will say that it's probably worth the money just because it's a really, really gorgeous mascara. And it has withstood my very, very watery eyes without flaking or being gross. I'm very, very impressed. Is that it? Was that everything? Oh, last but not least, I picked up a foundation. So this is the KVD True Portrait Liquid to Powder Foundation. Now, I picked this up because I was intrigued. I have never seen a liquid to powder foundation before in my life. I have no idea what that's about. I have no idea what it would even look like on the skin, but I'm curious. I'm curious, and it was marked down from $18 to $9.99, and then it had been sitting there for a good long while, so I was actually able to pick this up for $4, so that to me is not a bad price at all, and I'm, you know, curiosity is, we've got to figure it out. So you open it up, and first of all, I love KVD. KVD is one of those brands that if I had all the money in the world, I would own all of their products just because I adore the packaging. I adore KVD packaging so, so much. Like, Look at that. Look at that. Does that not look like an incredibly expensive bottle of foundation? It is so beautiful. I love that you have this little squeezy window in the center to gauge how much product is left. I love that it's this really ornate white bottle. It just screams luxury and high end to me. And it comes at a luxury high end price for sure. I haven't used this yet, but this is going to be in a new makeup Monday, probably coming this Monday. So be on the lookout for that. I didn't want to use it in a video until I could unbox it with you guys, but I am super excited to play with this. I got this in the shade Light 015. It's probably not going to be an awesome match for me, but that's all right. It looks like it's going to be just a little bit yellow, but we can kind of fix that with concealer and bronzer. We'll make it work. I am super excited to try this out though. It is super liquidy in there. I opened this and kind of like was messing with it, and it literally squirted out all over me. There is a reason I am always in a tank top. It is because never do your makeup in good clothes. You will ruin them 100% of the time. At least I do. I was doing my skincare today and I dropped facial oil all over my t-shirt. That's why my hair is hiding it. All of my tank tops have at least some kind of foundation oil, some kind of stain in them on them, because things happen when you're playing with makeup. I opened this up just to kind of see what it was like, and squeezed it and it squirted all over me. That's how it goes. But it is so super liquidy. It's like the weirdest thing. I'm trying not to get too much out. It's the weirdest thing. It feels like water. It is super, super thin. And then it blends out, but it's actually got really kind of amazing coverage. I'm excited to see what this does on my face, to see how it looks on my face. But then it dries down. And it has that little bit, it looks like a powder. It looks and it feels like a powder. It is the weirdest thing. I am super excited to try this out. So be prepared. Next Monday, we're going to play with this bad boy. We're going to play with all of the new goodies that we got from Birks. I really love everything that I got from Birks this time. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. As always, again, I'll post everything in the description box. If you have any questions at all, please let me know. Leave me a comment and I will 100% get back to you. Guys, don't forget to give this video a big old thumbs up before you leave. Let me know you're liking what I'm doing. If you're not subscribed, make sure you mash that subscribe button. You want to be here. I want you to be here. Let's just be together. Guys, as always, no filters, no edits, no fancy lighting. It's just me sitting in front of my camera, playing with some makeup, hoping you guys are enjoying what I'm doing. And until next time, my beautiful, amazing mamas, stay safe, take care of yourselves, and remember, you're important. Bye.